Hi, my name is Félix Buendia, and I'm a lecturer at Universitat Politécnica de Valencia. Today I'm going to present the research work addressed to developing mobile interactive tools that can be used in certain clinical guidance scenarios. This research work is developed in collaboration with other institutions such as the Universidad Europea or Universidad Católica de Valencia. As commented before, the current work is focused on the development of mobile interactive e-tools, which can be defined as pieces of software that run on the internet, or on a computer, or on a phone, or any other electronic device. And in this sense, the main purpose of this work consists in exploring how to develop this kind of tools to provide healthcare professionals with some example of clinical guidance resources especially addressed to nurse practitioners who can be interested in their practical application. In this context, two basic tools are used to allow this healthcare professional, first, the development of PowerPoint presentation that can be deployed as a kind of e-tool prototype, and then a learning authoring platform called Articulate to complete the e-tool implementation. According with this general purpose stated before, we need an approach to develop this kind of e-tools that can be used by to instruct or train nurse practitioners. The first stage of this approach consists in the design of the clinical guidance procedures that is going to be implemented in form of interactive tools. In this case, the PowerPoint presentation are used as a first prototype of this initial design that can include the definition of activity sequences during the procedure or those events which trigger them. The next step is based on the use of the Articulate Storyline application. We have here a screenshot to complete the implementation of the different activity sequences and exporting these results to scoring packages. Final stage will involve publishing exported scoring packages and enable the XAPI access to access and record track user interactions. A case study has been used to show the proposed approach that involves chest compression together with measurements of health rhythm defibrillation intervention in a context of a CPR or cardiopulmonary resuscitation scenario. This CPR scenario has been described in form first of a PowerPoint presentation. This is an example of a screenshot that represent potential activities in such a defibrillation scenario. Next, the PowerPoint presentation has been imported through the Articulate platform to label the different presentation guide slides and configure the events associated to these, for example, two branches of guidance activities in the clinical procedure. The final presentation using Articulate has been exported or published to a SCORM format, which was stored in the SCORM cloud platform. Ultimately, the published SCORM package was assessed by a group of students in a master's degree in nursing. An example of timeline of which represent the user accesses can be displayed. Finally, we can conclude this work that has introduced an approach addressed to developing this kind of tools that implements a certain type of interactive clinical procedure guidelines. This approach was based on the use of PowerPoint presentation to produce e-tool prototypes, which can further transform, for example, into an interactive application of CPR guide. Regarding the proposed approach, the starting experience reveals its versatility and adaptability.